faces. Is it getting cold? Different kinds of faces, some young and some old. Take me down to earth.
Everybody wants to take your baby home when you're in love with a beautiful woman.
Daphne, is that you?
No, love, it's Jackie. I won't be long. You watch your friends, better watch your friends, better watch your friends, better watch your friends when you're in love with a beautiful woman.
Becky.
Shut up.
I was only trying to help.
Oh, you. Back to bed.
Got to be at the hospital by now. What do you think? Oh, come on, there's a little bulge. What?
Oh, no!
Sorry I can't be with you today.
Oh, it's all right. You can look after Tony's wife instead.
Why isn't she at the pub? What's she doing here?
Making herself at home in my bathroom for a start.
Proper early bird I was this morning, Daph.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, thought I'd have a bath.
What's Wilson up to?
Sorry, Jackie.
He was in that shed of his own yesterday as well.
I mean, there is a shower of sorts in the B&B, but
it's not the same, is it? Not when you want a nice long soak.
Oh, yeah, long been the operative word. Sorry, Jackie. Excuse me.
Hiya, Frankie. It's Matt up.
What are you doing here?
But what does it look like, darling? I'm staying in Frankie's lovely B&B, and very comfy I am too.
I thought I told you to shove off.
Well, I know you did, sweetest, but I happen to like it here.
Well, Jackie, I want you gone, and furthermore, I want a divorce. So no arguments, that's my final word on it. OK.
Tell Matt I'll cash up with him later.
Yeah, all right.
Anyway, Frankie, I was just thinking, if you want to lift into the hospital, I'm going into town myself later on.
I'm actually all right, thank you.
Oh, OK.
Don't blame me, Tony. Somebody turns up at my first-class B&B wanting a bed. What am I going to do?
I know, it's just that I told her to bog off back to Liverpool ages ago, and I thought she had.
What's she doing here anyway?
I don't know.
OK.
Don't even want to think about it, to be honest with you. But whatever it is, it'll be trouble. Anyway, what are you doing tomorrow?
Why?
The water business. Hey, I told you I know a fella who made a million out of his.
Oh, you know a fella, do you?
I've already rang him. He's going to see us first thing in the morning.
It's a bit soon, isn't it? I've only just found out the water from the well's good enough to drink. We've no idea what's involved.
That's why we've got to go and see him, you fool, haven't we? To find out what's got to be done.
Right.
That'd be like putting our own money, won't it? Your water, my capital. Put the two of them together. Bingo.
Yeah.
Well, don't be so enthusiastic.
Well, it's just not the ideal time to be taking risks at the moment. Frankie's pregnant.
You what?
12 weeks.
Another kid. You've already got three. You must be crackers.
Thanks.
Oh, by the way, if that's for Mrs. Ansell, forget it. She doesn't want it. She's been on the phone.
Oh, great.
Oh, Matt!
What now?
Congratulations!
Cheers.
Frankie! Oh. I was early for me bit of business, so I thought I'd come and find you. How was it?
It was fine. Fine, yeah, thank you.
Good. Look at this lot, eh? Don't do this, don't do that. Ridiculous. You just do what you like, love. I know I did. Drank and smoked me way all through Emma. And look at her. Fancy another?
No, actually, I've got to get back.
Oh, come on, be a devil. I fancy one of those lovely oldie-worldy cream teas, all clotted cream, jam.
No, thanks.
Some other time, then.
Yeah,
yeah. Snooty little cow.
You can take that away for a start.
All yesterday I tried to save that fool, Mr. Brewer, and all last night.
I'm sorry to hear that.
We had the vet round three times, tried everything we could think of.
Well, I'm sure Mr.
All right, Sally, just let me tell him what happened. I mean, I got no bull at all now. It was my only one.
Like I said, I'm sorry. But it's nothing to do with me.
Here, look. This, Mr. Brewer. These.
And don't tell me you didn't put them here. I didn't. Well,
what's this then?
Well, it's one of my boxes. I can see that, but I've no idea how it got here.
Paul, please. We can't accuse him. We don't even know...
I think we do, Sally. What else is there in this field that would kill a bull, eh?
Well, you'll have to get a post-mortem to find out.
I spent every penny I had on that bull. I don't know what I'm gonna do.
About stupid old exams anyway.
Not me.
Come on. Sex the body.
What's he trying to do? Get a tan?
Hoping we'll admire his wonderful pecs, I expect.
Hey.
Oh, Dad. I am working. I've just got to go round to Emma's to get some notes.
Right, don't be long.
I won't.
Right, what have you been doing with the rubbish?
What?
All the weeds and the clippings.
Well, put them where you told me, of course.
You sure you've put everything in there?
Yeah, I put them in the compost, like you told me.
Well, you were very lucky by the sound of it, Frankie. Oh, and fancy the chap in the other car not even stopping. I think that's disgusting. Especially with you being pregnant.
Well, he's going to hardly know that, is he? Be fair.
Well, even so. Some boy racer, I dare say, with no thought for anyone else. I mean, if he'd hit you, are you sure you don't want to lie down?
No, I'm absolutely fine. Look, don't say anything to Matt. He's only going to worry. What?
Nothing. Oh, how'd he go to the hospital?
It's fine. So what's going on with you and Danny?
I said nothing. Are you sure everything's okay?
Yeah.
Really?
Yes, really, really.
Apart from nearly being...
Mother and baby are in rude health.
Oh, did anyone call about the veg boxes?
No, why?
Nothing.
You can have this back.
What?
And as of today, please regard my order as cancelled. Permanently. Yeah.
What was it all about? Oh, Matt, come on. If you know something, please just tell me.
We have been accused of dumping poisonous waste on Mr. Simmons' land.
What?
His prized bull ate it and the vet had to put it down.
Well, what are they accusing us for?
It was in our boxes. You give us a minute.
Right, OK, so that's what you were talking to Daddy about this morning, was it?
Yeah.
What, you think he dumped it?
I thought he did, yeah.
And?
He said he didn't, so I believe him.
I see, so what, we just sit and watch all these rumours spread until the entire village thinks it was us and then they ruin the rest of our business?
No, obviously not. But Simmons needed to calm down before I speak to him again.
Matt, no! No, this can't wait. You've got to go and talk to him.
OK.
You've got to go and tell him that it wasn't us.
All right, I'll go and see him.
Sooner?
Well, why didn't you tell me you nearly had a car crash this morning?
What?
Mum said.
Well, I told her not to say anything.
Why?
Because I didn't want you to worry about...
Exactly. Oh, I told you not to be long.
Yeah, well, I've been at Emma's place.
What's in the bag?
Books, Dad. Leave me alone.
Teenagers, eh? Who'd have them?
Girls and their fathers, eh? Let's hope Frankie has a boy. So much easier. When Matt was that age, he and I were like that. Very, very close.
Right. So, do you want a hand with those, Dad?
Ooh, yes, please. How did you get on in town?
Oh, quite well, thank you.
You got your bit of business done?
I took things a stage further, Daphne. Yes.
Huh? Mrs. Simmons, is your husband about?
He is, but he doesn't want to speak to you.
He's made a serious accusation against me.
I know, I'm really sorry. He just doesn't want to discuss it at the moment.
Yes, but it wasn't me, and I need to tell him that.
I'm sorry. There's nothing I can do.
You can't hide the evidence now, Mr. Brewer.
Don't be daft. Just looking.
But the damage is done.
But not by me.
Away.
Why? Is my room too?
Yeah, well, I'm trying to revise.
Two, four, five. Oh, blast! So when's this scan, Frankie?
Next week.
Funny, isn't it, being able to tell the sex? I'm not sure it's right, somehow. I was sure Matt was going to be a girl. I was going to call him Caroline. Feet off, Lucy.
Lucy?
I hate Becky.
Oh, come on.
I do? She won't even let me go in my own room.
Yeah, she's revising, you know that.
Everyone always takes her side.
I tell you what, why don't you have a look at a new book that I bought today? Here we go. There's some amazing pictures in it. Have a look at that. Yeah? That's how big your little baby brother or baby sister is right now. 9 centimetres. Good. Look, little toes, little fingers, even little tiny nails. See? Lucy.
I want to watch EastEnders.
To the green-eyed monster.
Tony.
Hello, Jackie. Nice to see you. Now, get lost.
I think we ought to have a little talk, don't you?
No.
About us getting back together. Oh, come off it, Tony. Who do you think you're kidding, eh? You know you can't live without me, so why don't we just pick up where we left off, as always.
No way, dear heart. And not while Loverboy's scum is still round the old bathtub.
Loverboy, as you so quaintly call him, left months ago.
Oh, so he's dumped you as well, has he?
No.
Well, my heart bleeds for you, but Jackie, there's no way I'm having you back. No way. And furthermore, I want you to sell the house and I want my half of the money.
Well, that's a shame, isn't it? Because it's in my name, as I seem to recall.
Yeah. But that was only for tax reasons.
Yeah, but I might not want to sell it. So, that's it, is it?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay. That's the way you want it.
can I do?
Simmons can't avoid me forever. He'll be at the cattle market tomorrow.
Shall I come?
I don't want you involved.
I am involved.
And you're expecting a baby.
It's not an illness.
I know. I just like you to take it easy. I want everything to be just right when he's born.
Or she.
Business back on track. Money in the bank.
That'll be a novelty. Hey, what I should do is try and replace all the customers that we've lost. Would Sir allow me to do that? Out. Oh.
Go up, Chris.
Donald Muxworthy at your service.
Frankie Brewer, actually, we met yesterday. You nearly ran me off the road at Postbox Cross.
Did I?
Afraid you did.
Well, you better come in then.
Go on, Scott.
Too, Matt. You haven't forgot, have you?
What?
I've seen the fella from the bottling plant. What's up with you?
I'm sorry, Tony. I'm sorry, mate. I've got a lot on my mind. It's just something I need to get sorted this morning.
Oh, yeah. Paul Simmons.
You know.
The whole village knows about it.
What are they saying?
Saying you dumped stuff in one of his fields and killed his bull. And you might be responsible for poisoning them ponies up on the moor.
What?
Well, did you?
Tony.
Well, I've got to ask. Away up. I'm off. Bottling plant tomorrow, eh? Can I take that as definite?
Right.
Anybody would think he was trying to avoid me.
Can I have a word?
There's nothing to say, Mr. Brewer. I had the post-mortem results this morning and his stomach was full of roots, just like the ones found in your rubbish. What do they call those again?
Water drop water.
Oh. So you know all about it then, do you?
I looked it up, yes, and I know how poisonous it is. But I didn't put it there, it's not my rubbish. I checked.
Oh, and I checked too. On your land. And surprise, surprise, your ditches have just been cleared out. And there are piles of those very same roots lying about all over the place. Now, isn't that a coincidence?
Well, if you'd have taken time to check my compost bins, you'd know where I put it.
So what are your boxes doing in my field, then?
I've no idea.
And why do people keep telling me they saw you putting them there? Your boxes in my field, full of rubbish.
Saw me?
Yes.
That's ridiculous. I've never set foot in that field till yesterday. If you carry on like this, you're going to ruin my business.
And what about my business, eh? That bull was worth £5,000. I'm going to want compensation through the courts if necessary.
Emma, we can't. It's our first exam tomorrow.
Who cares?
My dad for a start.
Well, don't tell him then. Just say you're going to meet some friends to do some revision or something. Oh, come on, Becky. I thought we were supposed to be best friends.
Yeah, but...
Mose and Pete are going to be there and loads of other boys. It's going to be really good. Danny will be there too, I bet. You're not going to let me down, are you, Bex?
Of course not.
Dad?
Hmm?
Can I ask you a favour?
This'll cost me. Go on.
There's a girl in my class and she's got these old exam papers, right? And she's invited a few of us around so we can test each other.
When?
Tonight.
No.
But if I stay in, I won't be revising. I'll be too nervous.
Absolutely not.
Oh, thanks a lot.
Exams are important.
Wish I'd realised that.
Are you telling me when you left school? You don't want to do this?
What do you think?
Do you want me to read that to you?
Oh, no, I can see clear as day. It says organic vegetables in conversion.
In conversion.
Never mind all that. Once a week, do you say?
Yeah.
Right, sign me on then.
Oh, right. Are you sure?
Well, it saved me having to go up to the shops, wouldn't it? And by all accounts, nearly killing folk.
Yeah, thank you. But rather than actually having to buy a vegetable box, would it not be maybe better to go and have an eye test?
No fear. Keep away from medical men, my old dad always used to say, and he lived to be 98.
Yeah, but if you could see to drive...
I can see well enough. I don't want some fool fiddling about with my eyes. You have a biscuit.
Thank you. Actually, not... I'm fine. Three new veg box customers. Not bad, eh?
Fantastic. Except while you've been out, two more have cancelled.
Oh. Well, have you managed to go and see Paul Simmons yet?
Yeah. And check this. People are actually saying they saw me dump the stuff now. Can you believe that?
Well, yeah, of course I can. That's what gossip is, isn't it? Chinese whispers.
Oh. Just when things were going well.
Hey. Come on, babies don't need that much. Can always fall back on Daphne's knitting.
Yeah.
Please.
No.
All the other parents have said, yeah, it's not fair.
Life isn't fair.
What are we talking about?
I just want to go out for a few hours to a friend's house to do some test papers, that's all.
Well, which friend is it?
Jill. My dad will drop me home. I won't be late or anything.
No.
Oh, Matt, I don't know.
What?
Well, last night, a bit of a change of scenery. Might do the world a good.
I can't do anything right, can I?
11 o'clock and not a minute later.
I know. Thanks, Frankie. See you, Dad.
Ta-da, lovey. See you tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Yeah, I've told him I'm staying with you. But I thought Jill's dad was taking us back.
There's no such person as Jill. I made her up.
So whose party is it?
Some guy in the sick form. He's got the keys to the place where he works.
How are we getting home?
We're not. It's an all-night party.
Granddad, where do babies come from?
Wild geese. You know when you see them flying overhead? Your dad showed you the other day, in a V?
Yeah.
Well, you can't see it from the ground, but they're carrying tiny little babies this big on their wings. And they're looking around for nice families to give them to. And then they find one, like ours is, they send it down.
A baby?
Yes.
How?
On a feather, of course, floated down.
Yeah, but where did they come from in the first place?
Stardust.
Stardust?
That's right.
Floss? Floss, where are you, girl? Flossie?
Mr. Maxworthy? It's Frankie. Are you all right? What's up?
I've lost Floss.
Maybe we should have a look in the house.
If she was around the house, I'd hear her. No, I'll go back and ask Paul.
Paul?
Paul Simmons, my neighbour. I only saw that daft wife of his earlier. I wouldn't believe anything she says.
Why wouldn't you?
Because you can't tell a sheepdog from a hamster, that's why. Hopeless.
How do you mean, hopeless?
A townie, frightened of everything. Sheep, cows, the lot. That bull that died, it came round here one day, got out and came into my yard. So Paul comes round with her in tow to fetch it back. She takes one look at it,
at Lars, like, snorting a bit, as bulls do. She jumps up on that wall there, screaming, shouting, you never heard anything like it. Help, help, rescue me! It's no good, is it? Not for a farmer's wife. Floss! Flossie!
Guess what Granddad told me, Frankie?
What?
About babies. Oh, shut up, Sam.
Yes, little boys should be seen and not heard.
Sorry, Emily.
Oh, yeah. Well, where have you been?
Discussing the water idea.
Guess what, Dad? I come from Stardust.
Oh, yeah?
I do, Lucy. And so do you, and so does everyone. Even Frankie's baby.
You are just so stupid.
I am not.
Yes, you are.
Shh, Lucy.
Fed up with hearing about babies anyway.
Oi, that's enough.
Well, I am. I wish we weren't having one. I wish you were dead.
Did you see that?
What?
The way Danny looked at you.
God, Bex, he really fancies you.
Just not.
He does, I can tell.
Go on, go and find him.
I can't do that.
Yes, you can.
And what about you?
I'll be fine.
So how did your little Facts Alive chat go then, eh?
Pretty good. Once we got into farm animals, we were home and dry.
What, Lucy?
Oh, don't worry about her. She'll love the baby more than anyone when it comes. Fire. It's nice.
Well, Daphne's gone to bed early.
Mm.
Becky's gone out.
Yeah.
No sign of Jackie, so I just thought... why not?
I knew there was a reason why I married you.
Because I is the perfect farmer's wife.
No room for improvement, then?
Hey, apparently not, no. Not according to my new friend. Muxworthy. Actually, he reckons I can give Sally Simmons some tips.
Well, for a city girl, you don't do bad yourself.
Thank you. Well, come on. Why are you in such a good mood? Surely Tony's not giving away free booze at the pub.
You must be joking. Oh, but I did bump into Hartley Simmons, Paul Simmons' brother. No love lost there. I think it was him that poisoned the bull.
Really?
Oh, yeah. They hate each other. Big family feud. Been going for years. So you know where I'll be going in the morning.
Yeah, well, in the meantime...
Ah, there you are. Now, I know it's a bit early for baby stuff, but... Ta-da!
Oh, thank you, Daphne.
What is it?
It's a baby blanket.
Of course.
Yeah, thanks, Mum.
Oh, you lit the fire. I think I'll stay down for a bit.
I can't believe how different you look.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nice of your dad to let you out like this. I mean, just before exams and...
Yeah.
I suppose he knows how hard you've been working, so... Well, he sort of trusts you.
Yeah.
It's more than my mum and dad ever did anyway. I was terrible at school. I never bothered. So, what exams you got tomorrow?
Look, can we just stop talking about exams? I'm sick of hearing about them.
Matt does know your ear, doesn't he?
Yeah, of course he does. What'd you take me for? Excuse me a minute.
Hello, Tony. I heard that Emma was out, leaving you all on your little unio.
What?
And we wouldn't want you to be lonely, would we?
Stop it. Stop it.
Thank you.
answer the bloody phone. It's past 12, you know.
Yeah, I know.
She hasn't even got a mobile with her. She won't be this late, Frankie, not if she was at some kid's house revising. Where is he?
I don't know.
I'm gonna go round there.
Thought you'd gone.
I missed the bus.
What are you like?
Sorry, Tony. Are the girls back?
What?
Are the girls back?
Thought you were staying over at your place.
No.
Who is it? Problems?
Just got absolutely no idea where she is.
I've seen this coming for a long time.
Well, Matt's gone round to Tony, see if he knows what's going on.
I dare say Emma's behind it. Never trusted her.
I just don't know how we've been so stupid. Just letting her go off, not even checking where she...
See me.
Oh, yeah. Good idea.
What are you waiting for?
Oh, Dad's gonna kill me.
You got going sooner or later. I've just driven like a maniac to get you here.
Oh, I know. Thanks. I'm sorry about dragging you away.
Look, it doesn't look like anyone's awake. You've probably got away with it.
I hope so.
Becky? Good luck tomorrow.
Becky, where have you been? Me and your dad have been going up the wall with Rummy.
You're busy revising. Just lost track of time.
Oh, well, at least you're back now. Are you all right?
Yeah, a bit tired.
All right, well, I'm going to go phone your dad before he alerts the military.
You haven't been revising, darling.
I can't do these exams.
Oh. There you go.
Thanks. I just can't think why you two are more worried, that's all.
Because we know Emma.
They'll be all right, Matt.
They're probably just fooling around with their friends and they haven't even noticed the time.
Night before exams?
Well, they're young, aren't they?
And you're only young once. Let them have a bit of fun while they can, that's what I say. Not that you can't have a bit of fun when you're old and grey, eh, Tone? Hello? Oh, hello, Frankie. Right. Right, I'll tell him. Bye, love. What did I tell you? Safe and sound at home in our own little bed, OK? Just leaving, Frankie. And I'll pick the girls up after school. Wilson's taking Sam to watch a cricket match, so I thought I would run Becky and Lucy into town for tea as a little treat.
I wonder what to do myself all this hell.
Come on then, you lot. Becky, do it good.
Good luck, Bex. You can do it.
Thanks. And Dad, sorry about last night.
Never mind. Carl needed to run out anyway. Oh, Tony and Jackie weren't exactly chuffed to see me last night.
But is it all back on again?
Well, you could say that.
Oh, yes, fantastic. At last, that means we'll get the dreaded Jackie out of our hair.
Sorry, folks.
I didn't mean...
No, I understand. Anyway, I'll be out of your hair in just a couple of days when I get a few things sorted.
I thought you were staying at the party.
Oh, shut up.
What happened?
I went home, didn't I? Bad move, because Dad's been horrible and making me take the stupid exams. Hey, we could bunk off.
No.
Oh, come on, Becky, you know I haven't done any revision.
I know. I'm going to take them.
So what that got ditch digger? So what that my brother and I don't see eye to eye?
Well, I don't want an argument, I just want to know...
And I've told you, I had nothing to do with it. What kind of nerve you have?
Okay, somebody dumped the stuff that killed the bull, and unlike me, you've got a motive.
I don't believe this. You lot come in here causing trouble.
Sorry?
Just goes to show how much you know about country people, doesn't it? Look, Mr. Brewer, the only sort of person to do something like that would be some bloody townie.
Townie?
Yeah, like you. Someone's so pig-ignorant they don't know what they're doing.
Hello, Sally. You got a minute?
So, you've called the police and the RSPCA?
Aye. No one's seen her. That's that, I'm afraid. She's gone for good. Poor old girl.
Hey. I'm so sorry. Right, why don't we go and have another look?
I've been up and down the field.
Oh, come on.
I've called and called. If she was there, she'd come.
Yeah, I saw you the other day, didn't I? Working away in your garden.
Yes.
So what were you doing exactly?
Making a pond. Well, clearing out an old one.
But that made a bit of a mess.
Yeah.
So what did you do with it?
What?
You know, all the mess, all the rubbish and weeds.
Put it in the farm dump. Look, I really think you better wait for Paul.
Look, about this bull business.
I don't want to discuss it.
But I do. We're going to lose all our customers at this rate. It's a really important time for Frankie and me. We're trying to establish a business and we're expecting our first baby together. We really can't afford anything to go wrong. So come on, Sally.
What?
Tell me what happened.
I don't know.
Well, I think you do.
What's he doing here?
Now, Mr. Simmons, please. Come on, tell him.
What? Tell me what?
Please.
I didn't know it was poisonous.
Sorry?
I was scared, Paul. You know how I am with bulls. I got halfway across the field and I forgot it was in there. It came at me. I couldn't get round it to the dump, so I left it by the gate.
You left what by the gate?
The rubbish from the pond. I didn't know the stupid thing would eat it.
I can see you.
Floss! Floss, hold on, girl. Hold on!
Oh, no. Right, no, you stay there. I'll go for it. Okay, let's see how we're going to get you out of here.
You okay?
Yeah, she's fine. You can just hang on and we can get you out. Come on, lovely.
There you are. Hello, my love, Flossie. Hey. Where have you been, then? I'm going to have to go to that old eye doctor after all.
What, because of Floss?
Aye. Could have lost her, couldn't I? If you hadn't come along, I'd never have found her. Not in a million years.
Well, I'm very glad about that. Nothing to do with nearly running me off the road, though.
No.
No. Oh, good. Good. So you'll get those drawn up as soon as possible, will you? Pardon?
Yes, it's very urgent. Right, well, I'll be in later on to sign them, OK? Bye. Bye.
Oh!
Listen, your baby's going to be fine. You're going to be fine.
I need Matt.
I know, and we'll find him. Can you make it to the car? Look, lean on me. Go on. There you go. Deep breaths. Oh!
Granddad?
Uh-huh.
You know about babies?
Yeah.
You got it all wrong.
Did I?
You want me to tell you what really happens?
Let's make our picnic and get to the cricket match first, okay?
That was Frankie in that car, Granddad. Where's she going?
So, Mr. Brewer, you're thinking of selling my bottles of water along with your vegetables, are you?
No, I think you've got it the wrong way round. We've got our own water. We're just here to see how it's done.
I'm sorry. I don't understand.
Well, when I say,
Tom! You didn't tell me you were going into the business yourselves.
Didn't I?
No, you did not. Furthermore, you gave me the very distinct impression that you wanted to buy my water.
Did I?
Did he?
Yes, he did.
Well, all I can say is I'm very, very sorry.
And you will be unless you leave my premises immediately. And I'll head that camera off
Excuse
you as well.
Excuse me, this photograph of my wife and children on that.
Mr. Gammon, that's not very nice. Oi! I was asked supposed to know what you told him.
Because I told you.
No, you didn't.
Why else do you think he was showing us around? He thought we were there to buy his ruddy water. And now we're marked men. No, nothing matter, Matt, I'm telling you. That bottling idea is vital to my plans.
Ah, so you keep saying. Don't forget it's my water, will you?
Of course not. Your water, my idea, our profits. Right. Look, you know I told you I've got to make some money?
Yeah.
Well, strictly between us, it's for the pub.
The pub?
Yeah. If you want to buy it, it's just come on the market.
Hello? Who? Hello? I can't get a signal. What, you're going to buy the pub?
Yeah, and I'm determined to get it. I've got some money stashed away. I was up for half of the house, but the devil won't sell it, will she? So, that's why I've got to get this water thing up and running, if you know what I mean.
Sorry?
Well, so I can borrow against it. The pub won't sell for ages. Pubs never do.
Right.
So I reckon I've got about 6 months.
That sounded like Jackie, by the way.
Well, don't ring back, whatever you do.
Matt, this is Jackie. Matt, listen, I need you to call me as soon as you can on my mobile. OK?
This is Parker here. Please restore my box delivery as of next week. Thank you.
Well, Mr. P, I might, and I might not.
Matt, this is Jackie. Matt, listen, I need you to call me as soon as you can on my mobile. Okay?
Everybody told me to take things easy and I've just been so stupid.
Shh.
I've been running around fields all day, chasing after dogs and...
It's not your fault, darling.
I'm so sorry, Matt.
Don't be daft.
But I really wanted this. I really wanted to have our baby.
So did I. I love you.
How could it possibly be your fault?
I said I wanted you to be dead.
That wouldn't make any difference. It's just a natural thing, Lucy. Sometimes a baby isn't meant to be. We'll keep this as our little secret, eh? Till next time.
Morning.
Morning.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Oh, letter for you, Jackie.
Thank you, Daff.
Sorry, Frankie.
Thank you, sweetheart.
There'll be another time, Duck. You'll see.
Thank you, Tony. That's very sweet.
Don't thank me. I'm just a delivery boy.
Not about the baby, either. From Paul and Sally Simmons with apologies for the trouble caused.
That's a reality, eh?
Aww. That'll be me and you soon, eh, Tom? Proper little Darby and Joan we're gonna be, aren't we?
What's this?
Sale of the house.
Well?
Well, didn't I tell you I had it on the market?
No.
Whoops, sorry. Anyway, guess what I've done with the money? Go on, guess.
What?
I've bought the pub. I am going to be your boss. Well, isn't that a scream? Eh?
You're going out with Adam Kamek?
Just a business dinner to discuss our mutual interests. You're not jealous, are you?
Hey, you must be joking.
Look, if Frankie's lost her baby, can we help her find it? Dad, Dad!
What's going on?
I found it. Come and see.
I can't believe that a sophisticated girl like you doesn't get bored with country life from time to time.
He was just being friendly.
Friendly?
Yeah, in a way, it's kind of a compliment.